Elon Musk, the CEO of the electric car company Tesla, has been called a genius, a visionary. But this year he got less noticed for his brilliance than his behavior, with stories about self-inflicted wounds, like capricious tweeting and public pot smoking. The 47-year-old billionaire has said 2018 has been excruciating, the most painful year of my career. When he joined as co-founder of the company 14 years ago, he had no experience in the auto industry. He was guided by a dream, to build cars that don't harm the environment in an effort to save the planet. But this year Musk had to save his company. Tesla had been losing money for nearly its entire existence, its debt is in the billions, and it was bleeding cash. Everything was riding on its ability to mass produce its new sedan, the Model 3, an affordable so-called everyman car. But over the summer, when Elon Musk was in production hell, as he called it, working round the clock to make enough Model 3 seconds to show a profit, he began acting, well, weird. Lastly Stahl, there are people who say that the company cannot survive without you. An Elon Musk, oh, I don't think that's true. Yeah. Lastly Stahl, dash there are people who say the company cannot survive with you. Elon Musk, haha. That's hilarious. Lastly Stahl, they say it's because of the way you acted over the summer doing things that seemed impulsive, un-CEO-ish. Elon Musk, well, first of all, I am somewhat impulsive. And I didn't really want to try to adhere to some CEO template. Well, he certainly accomplished that. Especially this past year when he began picking needless fights on social media. He called a diver of the Thai cave rescue a pedo, as in pedophile. He sold 20,000 flamethrowers online and he smoked weed during a podcast. Lastly Stahl, what about the pot? Elon Musk, I do not smoke pot, as anyone who watched that podcast could tell, I have no idea how to smoke pot. Or anything. I don't know to smoke anything, honestly. Lastly Stahl, here are some of the words written about you. Elon Musk, yeah, sure. Lastly Stahl, not the whole time Elon Musk, it's a lot of words. Laugh. Lastly Stahl, dash over this summer. Erratic, unstable, reckless, operatic. Elon Musk, operatic? Ah, that's not bad, actually. I kinda like that one. I'm just being me. I mean, I was certainly under insane stress and crazy, crazy hours. But the system would have failed if I was truly erratic. Lastly Stahl, you tweet a lot. Elon Musk, I use my tweets to express myself. Laughter. Lastly Stahl, yes. Oh my god Elon Musk, some people use their hair. Laughter. I use Twitter. Lastly Stahl, well, but you use your tweeting to kind of get back at critics. Elon Musk, rarely. Lastly Stahl, you kind of have little wars with the press. Elon Musk, Twitter's a war zone. If somebody's gonna jump in the war zone-y, it's, like, okay, you're in the arena. Let's go. I want to be clear. I do not respect the SEC. I do not respect them. His Warzone-y tweeting drew fire when out of the blue in August he tweeted, quote, am considering taking Tesla private at $420. Funding secured. The SEC disputed that claim and charged him with securities fraud. The case was settled with Musk agreeing that his communications relating to the company including Twitter would be overseen by his board. Lastly Stahl, have you had any of your tweets censored since the settlement? Elon Musk, no. Lastly Stahl, none? Does someone have to read them before they go out? Elon Musk, no. Lastly Stahl, so your tweets are not supervised? Elon Musk, the only tweets that would have to be say reviewed would be if a tweet had a probability of causing a movement in the stock. Lastly Stahl, and that's it? Elon Musk, yeah, I mean otherwise it's, hello, First Amendment. Like freedom of speech is fundamental. Lastly Stahl, but how do they know if it's going to move the market if they're not reading all of them before you send them? Elon Musk, well, I guess we might make some mistakes. Who knows? Lastly Stahl, are you serious? Elon Musk, nobody's perfect. Lastly Stahl, look at you. Elon Musk, I want to be clear. I do not respect the SEC. I do not respect them. Lastly Stahl, but you're abiding by the settlement, aren't you? Elon Musk, because I respect the justice system. Abiding also meant he had to relinquish his position as chairman of the Tesla board. He's been replaced by board member Robin Denholm. Lastly Stahl, did you handpick her? Elon Musk, yes. Leslie Stahl, the impression was that she was put in to kind of watch over you. Elon Musk, yeah, I mean that's not realistic. I mean I'm the largest Leslie Stahl, like a babysitter dash Elon Musk, yeah! It's not realistic in the sense that I am the largest shareholder in the company. And I can just call for a shareholder vote and get anything done that I want. Leslie Stahl, so do you think you'll want to go back to being dash to being chair? Elon Musk, no, I don't think I actually just prefer to have no titles at all. With or without titles, there's something larger than life about Elon Musk. He has a cult following. One of Silicon Valley's most successful and versatile entrepreneurs, he has, beyond cars, built powerful rockets with reusable boosters. This one launched a record 64 satellites into orbit. He's digging a tunnel deep underground to deal with traffic congestion. And in each case, he started a company. Leslie Stahl, did you have a lot of money? Did your family give you a lot of money to start all of this? Elon Musk, no. Leslie Stahl, you grew up in South Africa. Elon Musk, yes. Leslie Stahl, yeah. Elon Musk, I left when I was 17, by myself. I had a backpack of clothes and a suitcase of books. And that's it. Leslie Stahl, did you have a happy childhood? Elon Musk, no, it was terrible. Leslie Stahl, are you serious? Elon Musk, yes. Leslie Stahl, why was it terrible? Elon Musk, it was very violent. It was not a happy childhood. Leslie Stahl, I do know that you were bullied at school. Elon Musk, I was almost beaten to death, if you would call that bullied. And he's described his father as emotionally abusive. Elon Musk, my father has serious issues. Leslie Stahl, okay well, so you didn't have a happy childhood. Elon Musk, no. It's no surprise then that as an adult he's a fighter, determined to succeed and prove everyone wrong, as when he waged a battle this year to avoid Tesla's bankruptcy by boosting production of its newest electric car, the Model 3. At the factory in Fremont, California, he complained bitterly about all the naysayers and critics who were gunning for his failure. Elon Musk, there's been relentless criticism, relentless and outrageous and unfair. Because what actually happened here was an incredible American success story. All these people work their ass off day and night to make it happen. And they believe in the dream. And that's the story that really should be told. The story is how he set and met the production target of 5,000 Model 3 seconds a week and made Tesla profitable. But the effort nearly bankrupted the company. Elon Musk, if you're trying to step up to something which is, you know, 1,000% more than any other program that you've ever done, it's necessarily dash you have to bet the company. There's no option. Leslie Stahl, so in other words, if you hadn't met it, you would have died. Elon Musk, it was life or death. We were losing $50, sometimes $100 million a week. Running out of money. Leslie Stahl, you were losing $100 million a week. Elon Musk, yeah! That's scary. His two assembly lines weren't churning out cars fast enough. Failure was imminent, until his lightbulb moment, create a third assembly line in a big tent in the Tesla parking lot. Elon Musk, this whole thing that you see here was a pretty miraculous effort by the team to create a general assembly line out of nothing in 3 weeks. Leslie Stahl, this went up in 3 weeks. Elon Musk, yeah! So those, you know, betting against the company were right by all conventional standards that we would fail. But they just did not count on this unconventional situation of creating an assembly line in a parking lot in a tent. Leslie Stahl, and this last-minute push. Elon Musk, it increased our output by 50%. Musk was a champion of automation. So his original assembly lines were full of robots. But the robots kept breaking down. Walk along this new line in the tent, and all you see are, well, humans. He tweeted, excessive automation at Tesla was a mistake. To be precise, my mistake. Humans are underrated. Elon Musk, people are way better at dealing with unexpected circumstances than robots. As you know. Yeah, workers, yeah, yeah. Elon Musk, yeah. He pushed his workers hard to meet the 5,000 a week deadline. But he pushed himself even harder, out on the factory floor day and night troubleshooting and fixing workland slowdowns. Elon Musk, I think there was like literally 1 week where I actually worked 120 hours and just didn't leave the factory. I didn't even go outside. I wanted to make it clear to the team. They needed to see that however hard it was for them, I would make it worse for me. And it paid off. Tesla announced in October it was profitable for the first time in years. The Model 3 is all electric, can go from 0 to 60 in 3 seconds and drive over 300 miles on a single battery charge. Musk wanted to show us the autopilot feature, the car drives itself. Leslie Stahl, but right now, you're driving. Right now. Elon Musk,
yeah!
Dings, but now I'm not. Leslie Stahl, dash now you're not driving at all. Elon Musk, not doing anything. No hands. No feet. Leslie Stahl, you feel safe? Elon Musk,
yeah!
And just as I got used to this Elon Musk, I'm not dash it's changing lanes by itself. Leslie Stahl,
oh!
Oh my goodness. Laugh. Elon Musk,
yeah, pretty wild.
Leslie Stahl,
wow!
Another thing that was supposed to be a
wow
was the price, just $35,000. That was a goal not met, it costs around $49,000, and if you customize it, which many customers do, you can quickly reach $60,000. Leslie Stahl, it's not a car for the everyman, which is what you set out to build. Elon Musk, it's getting there. We're not that far from being able to produce the $35,000 car, and that'll be ready in probably 5 or 6 months. Leslie Stahl,
all right.
Here you go. You've already set a new deadline. Right?
5 or 6 months.
Elon Musk, that's just dash that's just my guess. Leslie Stahl,
okay.
It's not Elon Musk, it's not, like, some promise dash or so help me God and strike me dead.
Leslie Stahl,
you are notorious for setting, you know, these deadlines for yourself that no one thinks you can meet, and you often don't meet. And I'm just wondering why you do that.
Elon Musk,
well, I mean punctuality is not my strong suit.
I think, well, why would people think that if I've been late on all the other models, that I'd be suddenly on time with this one?
Leslie Stahl,
your naysayers say that you lie.
That's the way they interpret it.
Elon Musk,
people should not ascribe to malice at which can easily be explained by stupidity.
Laughter, so dash so it's,
like, just because I'm, like, dumb at dash at predicting dates does not mean I am untruthful. I don't know dash I dash we've dash I never made a mass-produced car. How am I supposed to know with precision when it's gonna get done? He's also had to deal with complaints about conditions inside Tesla's factories.
Leslie Stahl, there are charges of unreported injuries, excessive hours, abusive conditions.
Elon Musk,
well, it's important to emphasize that there's been an aggressive campaign by the IAA to absolutely attack Tesla with a load of nonsense and dash in order to try to unionize the company.
Leslie Stahl,
so you think they drummed up these charges?
Elon Musk,
yes.
These are utter nonsense.
Leslie Stahl,
well, there are several investigations by the press and by regulators in California about injuries on the job. Breathing toxic fumes, stress injuries, over 100 ambulance calls.
Elon Musk,
I don't think that's correct.
Elon Musk, I was literally living in the factory.
If these dash if there's, like, toxic fumes, I'm breathing them.
Okay?
But there've been other concerns. A string of senior managers and engineers left this year. The company is still billions in debt. And yet Tesla is expanding, adding to its workforce, while rival General Motors announced it's planning to lay off some 14,000 employees and idle plants.
Leslie Stahl,
would you want to buy some of those plants, those factories that they're closing down?
You're shaking your head yes.
Elon Musk,
it's possible that we would be interested.
If they were going to sell a plant or not use it that we would take it over.
GM also announced that it will double its investment into developing electric cars, and Elon Musk is celebrating.
Leslie Stahl,
why do you want the competition?
Elon Musk, the whole point of Tesla is to accelerate the advent of electric vehicles and sustainable transport and trying to help the environment. We think it's the most serious problem that humanity faces. I'm not sure if you know it, but we open sourced our patents, so anyone who wants to use our patents can use them for free.
Leslie Stahl,
your patents are open sourced?
Elon Musk,
yeah!
If somebody comes and makes a better electric car than Tesla and it's so much better than ours that we can't sell our cars, and we go bankrupt, I still think that's a good thing for the world.
Leslie Stahl,
and you'll sleep at night.
Elon Musk,
yeah,
because somebody's making some pretty great cars. Yeah. Produced by Shakir Baran. Associate Producer, Natalie Jimenez-Peel.